10th of August 2013, Worthing. And this is the home of the International Worthing Birdman.
And these people up here, you know, they're very stupid, but they're quite brave at the same time.
Yeah, come on!
Gusty, good, pretty much spot on, really.
Oh, I'm quite nervous.
The worrying thing is just messing around up there with attached to a very large wing, as you can imagine.
Okay, we're doing it like this. Yeah, cool. This is where we sail in the history books.
Get it flying as soon as you can without losing any height. Then you can rely on the ground effect off the water.
If you lose control of the glider and it turns over, flips over, obviously it then flips off the platform with you attached to it. That's not good.
Go!
Come on, baby! Come on! Let's do it! On one, hold on! Hold on, mate!
3, 2, 3,
go!
Joyce and Edward Chilcott.
Look at my old boots!
Look beautiful in flight, I gather. Landed pretty well. There was a bit of a breakage on the way down. But when we left the craft in the water, it was in a pretty good state. When it was then dragged through the waves to the beach, it arrived in about 9 pieces.
You're a lunatic. I thought you was going backwards into the wooden groin with your head today, but you were lucky you landed on your face.
You flew, well, fell with grace.
You crashed, Tony flew.
We will take that and we will turn it into something that can soar.
It used to be a beautiful frame. It is now sort of just a mess. This is the height. I do believe the leading edge may have burst on impact. This is the wing. So I think it's probably irretrievable, this wing.
We've got to get the band.
Although, well, maybe we can use that tomorrow. I don't know. This is the tail plate. This ripped off when we landed. But actually, the tail plane is in pretty good nick.
Point out that this is a bit ideal. In the
what can happen from a fall of 12 metres? I mean, it's the metal.
I've noticed. Look, it's where you drilled.
The metal is just simply ripped off.
I've deemed it too dangerous.
Come here, mate.
Or it was deemed too dangerous. The problem was the wind got under the wings, and the I just started bending. It's actually ripped off. If you look down there, you'll see that bit of wood. It's splintered. Shattered.
Here I am with Warwick Davis, and Warwick, we just wanted to know, what did you think of the Worthing Birdman today?
Yeah, it was very interesting. A lot of crazy people, obviously. And yours was quite an impressive flight, though, wasn't it? Because it looked good to start with. Everything was full of air, and then you jumped off, and then it all went wrong.
Yeah, well, this actually survived the kite, but unfortunately, the frame. Disintegrated. This is the result. This is actually the remains of our aircraft.
It's dangerous, isn't it?
It is a bit dangerous, but we're fine. We're good.
How was this? What did this used to be?
This was the International Kite Tandem.
That was an extendable painting.
Yeah.
Well, no,
actually,
seriously.
And then what?
That's it.
Do you really think that would have made you fly?
Probably not.
No. Tim, you think we're idiots for doing this? I think we are pioneers. And we're winners. I'm a winner. I win. That's what I do.
Corner of my eye, that looks like a kite surfing kite to me.
It's Edward Chilcott, Nicholas Joyce, and say the guys did fly this craft yesterday and they're back today in the Leonardo class and say make their way up the ramp. A little bit of trouble controlling this, I think, yesterday in the gusting wind. Hopefully it's not quite so bad today.
What do you think, Dave? How's it look from your angle?
Well, the climate is certainly upright at the moment. The guys are trying to control it. Obviously, it is very light, but I think they were ready to go any second. The stop sign is down.